Greetings, everybody. Welcome to an impromptu road trip. I'm here with Amy. Want to say hi, Amy?
Hello.
Hello. We are driving from Phoenix down to Willcox, Arizona. Southeast Arizona is where we're going. You've seen some past episodes of us down there, but anyway, we are going to be spending the night down there and doing some adventuring because it's about a 3-hour drive from Phoenix, and it's a Saturday, and Amy and I just needed to really get out of the house and do some exploring. But yeah, we didn't want to do a day trip this time. It's a little bit much. But anyway, we're going to stop and see some things along the way, and we thought it might just be fun to just have you tag along on this road trip. So let's see what kind of trouble we can get into. You can see downtown Phoenix off to the right over there, the little skylines. Phoenix isn't a huge metropolis by any means. The downtown area, it's kind of neat. There's some like corporate stuff down there, some historic stuff too, but for the most part, it's really alive during the week when people are working. Probably not so much right now, but other than that, yeah, Phoenix, not much hopping down there usually, in my opinion. Alrighty, so we are out of Phoenix proper, Interstate 10 South, heading towards Tucson, the next major city. There's some other stops along the way, but anyway, wanted to just chat a little bit, let you guys know what's been up. So you guys see us every week, so you're seeing a lot of footage, I think, around now. We're on my trip up to Utah, and Utah was around the last time that I actually filmed, if you can believe that, probably about a month and a half, 2 months ago. I got back from that trip, and I got really sick. I actually got the shingles, and it took a while to actually figure out what was going on. It manifested itself on my head and my face. You can actually see the remnant, that crater that's here. That is still, almost 2 months later, that is still there. I mean, it's healed, but I'm wondering if I'm gonna have a scar or something. It's just nasty. But anyway, I'm not gonna go into all the details there. Outside of that, been really busy at work. I have a major project that's kind of started. Been working crazy, crazy hours. Sometimes I've been working 7 days a week, so that's been really rough. Amy and I needed a break. We needed to get out. That's part of what we're doing today. Also, though, it's the beginning of the Halloween season. It's almost October here. So Amy and I wanted to jump on the Halloween and autumn bandwagon here on YouTube. And we're heading to Southeast Arizona. We've got some stuff that's kind of turned out to be a little bit of a tradition that you're going to be seeing here soon enough. But that's part of the reason for this trip also. And someone happens to be a gigantic Halloween nut, like of epic proportions. You don't even realize. So she's laughing. But yeah, it is. Yeah, I mean, I like it too, I must admit. But anyway, yeah, so that is what we are up to. All right, so Amy and I are making a little bit of a pit stop, our first little side stop of our road trip here. This is kind of a quasi tradition. I say quasi because we don't usually do this every time, but we've made a pit stop in Casa Grande, Arizona, right off of Interstate 10, or as other people pronounce it, Casa Grande. So I'm not sure what the preferred pronunciation is, to be honest. I don't care. Anyway, yeah, there's a little treat that we're going to indulge in here. So let me show you what I'm talking about. All right, so this is our first little pit stop that I told you about. This little place called Eegees. Amy and I love this place. And I never really picked up on this until maybe a few years ago. I had a coworker, I think, who lived in the Tucson area that always talked about this place. We don't really have these in Phoenix proper. I think there might be a couple here and there, but usually I think this is more of a Tucson thing. Let's go in and I'll tell you what an Eegees is. All right, so we got our little drinks here. What is known as an Eegee, if I'm not mistaken. When I order, I just say I need like a strawberry Eegee or whatever. So I think the drinks are actually called Eegees. And the restaurant is also called Eegees. But anyway, it's kind of like a frozen, almost like a Hawaiian shaved ice drink type of thing. And you can kind of mix flavors together. I ordered a strawberry lemon mixed together, so they'll do that for you. Let's see how this tastes. So good. So why do we stop here? So for me, like I said, it's kind of like a Hawaiian shave ice type of concoction, and maybe even like an Italian ice in a drink form. It's really hard to pull it up through the straw, but it's so good. The thing that I like is it's so flavorful. It's not like your average like snow cone or slushy drink that gets really watery. It's the flavor maintains like almost the whole time. Unlike any drink like this that I've had, they are so, so good. Okay, so it's time to resume our journey here. We still got a long way to go. I think Casa Grande is closer to Phoenix than it is Tucson, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, we just wanted to get that delicious treat. So yeah, like I said, I think this is more of a Tucson thing. So if you live in Phoenix and you didn't know about Eegees, or even if you don't live in Phoenix and you're vacationing or driving on Interstate 10 towards Tucson, just keep that in the back of your head. Yeah, you really want to check that out. It's something special, I think.
How's it going over there with your straw and your lack of spoon?
It's so good, but it's so much work. It's just, yeah, you suck, and then you get a little bit. But yeah, it's just having a spoon would be much better, but it's still worth it for the little intermittent rewards. But Shane?
Suck, suck, suck.
Some pretty scenery out here with those mountains in the background. I think these are pecan trees or some kind of nut. Just kind of randomly out here in the middle of the desert. Pretty sure we looked this up before. And I'm gonna say pecans. I think pecan trees are pretty large. I think they have a lot of those in Texas, if I'm not mistaken.
They do.
So the interesting looking mountains kind of off to the right there. That's known as Picacho Peak. Did you know that that is the site of the furthest west Civil War engagement? 1862, Union cavalry skirmished with Confederate pickets that were coming out of Tucson. Really neat. I didn't know that for the longest time. So I made a quick pit stop here. It's not open right now, and it's very loud because we're right off the interstate right there. So Amy and I stopped here at Rooster Cogburn Ostrich Ranch about a year ago. We had a really good time here. I'll put a link in the description down below to that video, but yeah, you get to feed lots of interesting animals. I can't talk. My mouth is still cold from drinking the Eegees. so I'm kind of thawing out. But anyway, yeah, my favorite thing here, you get to feed what are called lorikeets, these birds. They give you this like cup of nectar and you kind of hold your arms out and the birds land on you. Lots of fun. So if you're ever driving on Interstate 10 past Picacho Peak, that's Picacho Peak right there. You definitely want to stop here. A lot of fun. All right, yeah, so it's really loud out there. Tried to talk to you guys out there. Two problems. The Eegee, it just, my mouth is numb. You got the numbness from the sucking action. You've got the numbness of the cold. And trying to enunciate is challenging right now, so. Plus, the sound of the freeway is just, it's amazing how loud that is. I forgot. But anyway, yeah, this is a cool area. And I also wanted to mention at Picacho Peak, there's also a state park. You can hike to the top of it, and you can also camp there. They've got hiking trails, so that's something we have not yet visited here on the Cactus Atlas, but sometime soon we will promise to make the trip down here. We are right outside of downtown Tucson now. Can see it out the window here on the left. Not a really big downtown, but as far as towns in Arizona goes, I'd say it's pretty big. Amy and I have spent quite a bit of time around Tucson, the surrounding area, made many videos down around here. The Sonora Desert Museum, Old Tucson, and we've got lots of plans for some other things to go check out, but we've never really explored downtown. I know it's the home of the University of Arizona, so, but outside of that, for any of you guys that are familiar with Tucson, I'd be interested to know if there's anything of particular interest in the city area to explore sometime. So always up for some recommendations for those. So for those of you that know this area, drop us a comment, let us know. I always love this stretch of Interstate 10. You just keep seeing these signs for the thing. The thing, the thing, the thing. It just never ends. For the last 20 miles or so, it's just billboard after billboard. The thing.
What is it?
Alrighty, so Amy and I, as I just mentioned, stopped at the thing, the roadside attraction. She thinks we were there for a couple hours. I want to say a little bit less, but she might be right. When we entered the place, what I can tell you for sure, it was still plenty daylight. The shadows were long, but it wasn't really sunset time yet. Came out, and it is dark. The sun is well set. We're probably, what do you think, Amy, about 15, 20 minutes away from our hotel?
Yep, just about.
Yeah, so, that really exceeded my expectations. I think Amy and I were saying, or I was saying, should we save it for tomorrow? You know, I was kind of tired. Just wanting to get back to the hotel and just get settled in for the night, get some food. I mean, it's still early. It's only 6:30, but I'm glad we went. It really energized me. It was really exciting, so I can't wait to share that video with you guys here. Definitely worthy of the Halloween season, just how, because that's kind of kooky and wacky, so I suspect we're going to have that one released here in a few weeks, so keep an eye out. All right, we've arrived at the Holiday Inn Express in Willcox, Arizona. Let's go see if this place is okay or not. And look at how many charge stations they have here. I mean, that's pretty crazy. I guess it's right off of Interstate 10. So, yeah, if you're driving an electric vehicle, they more than have you covered here. So the lady that checked us in said they're actually sold out tonight. So pretty popular hotel, I suppose. Do have a little snack bar here. It's pretty nice. Dude, this is awesome. Have a good night. Thank you, man. And here is our room at the Holiday Inn Express in Willcox, Arizona. Let's check her out. So you got storage stuff here. And if you're going out for a big night on the town, you got a mirror here on the way out so you can make sure you're keeping it fresh. And I mean, this is kind of like what was advertised, what I was expecting. I mean, it's very clean. We got the two queen bedroom, very small, dinky TV, but they do have a microwave. And as I showed you downstairs, you also have some stuff you can buy to make in the microwave, and no body parts in the fridge. So that's always a good sign. Let me do a quick comfort check here. I can tell you right off the bat if it's gonna be good or not. All right, so this mattress, not the best ever. I mean, it's a little, definitely sinks in a little bit, a little springy, I guess. Pillows are decent, but my initial check of the mattress is, I think it's had some use, but it'll do. And let's check out the restrooms. So cleanliness factor, very clean. Modern factor, meh, not bad. Could be a lot more outdated, but it's clean. Plenty of towels and stuff. Shower, I kind of dig this, what they did here. I mean, it's not the most expensive marble. I'm sure it's not even marble. It's probably some imitation thing, but yeah, I mean, it's, you get what you pay for. So Amy and I were starving. We were going to go to a Mexican restaurant in downtown Willcox, but we decided not to because the lady up front here kept mentioning over and over that they've sold out here tonight, and I think was kind of insinuating that we may be out of luck for a parking spot if we're not careful. So Amy and I were afraid to drift too far away from the hotel. So we decided to just go to the truck stop right next to here, and they have a Popeye's fried chicken joint. So she and I have never had Popeyes, I don't think, right? You've never had it in your entire life, and nor have I. I don't know how I've never had it. So this is actually a first, so I feel like it's film worthy, so let's dig in. So here's what I'm dealing with here. I got like their, Amy and I got a 3-piece chicken and then a 5-piece, and then we kind of split it. So we each have 4 pieces, so you get your, they're chicken tenders, by the way, and a biscuit. Got some barbecue sauce and mashed potatoes. Was gonna have french fries, but they didn't have fries there, so I guess this is a historic occasion. Truck stop Popeyes, take one. So there's my chicken. It's actually nice and crispy. You can see. If it looks crisp on camera right there, it's because it is. Listen to this crunch. Actually, that is quite good, I think. I don't know, Amy. Amy's over there eating, or she's about to start, but that actually exceeds my expectations, to be honest with you. Okay, so as I mentioned, I wanted to get fries, but they didn't have fries. So I got their mashed potatoes. Actually, once again, better than I would have thought. All right, so the only last thing I have now is the biscuit. I would say the biscuit's pretty important, right? So Amy says hers is good too so far. I think I love that chicken from Popeyes. You know, one other thing that I feel like I need to readdress maybe or restate, because now I'm all paranoid. I kind of was looking in the viewfinder. This thing just looks nasty, doesn't it? Like, you should have seen what it looked like a month or so ago. In fact, it's funny, just a quick
insert photo
here. Basically, I got back from Goblin Valley State Park, camping there, the Utah video. Some of you may have seen the campground episode with the brown water, that whole thing. I'll put a link in the description down below if you haven't seen that yet. But I came back. This thing was like all pussy. I just had this like open sore. It looked like a staph infection. In fact, it looked so much like a staph infection that urgent care diagnosed me as having impetigo and gave me antibiotics. So we actually put on a previous video kind of a criticism about, you know, couldn't say for sure if I got that from the campground or not, but, you know, I was like, but then we removed it because that wouldn't be fair, because it ended up being shingles, as I mentioned earlier. Had like all these like really painful sores on this side of my head, this sore, and then I got this eye infection to boot, and it took a week to figure it out, but an ophthalmologist finally said, I walked in, he looked at, took one look at me, and he's like, oh yeah, you got shingles. I'm like, what? And you know, I'm not 50 yet, so I still got a little ways to go, so haven't gotten the vaccine. Learned that even if you want to get the vaccine before 50, your insurance probably won't cover it, so you're probably going to spend $300-$400 out of pocket. So no need for me to get it right now, because having just had it, one of my doctors said I'm very unlikely. I have enough antibodies now to fend it off for now. But my PSA for you guys out there is, if you're over 50 and you haven't gotten a shingle shot, seriously, you know, don't mess around. I got, like I said, I got it on my face. People, you can get it on your body and your ear and all sorts of different places. But wherever you get it, you don't want to mess with it, man. It was horrible, horrible, horrible. So, and you can still see this 2 months later. Like, I still have this crater that's healing, and I'm wondering, is it gonna ever fill back in? I don't know. Starting to get really paranoid. Good morning, everyone. I didn't realize, but the pool was right below us this whole time. And across the street over there is that truck stop where we had Popeye's fried chicken last night. Okay, so we're about to continue the road trip. We've spent the night now. Not a bad sleep for me. I mean, like Amy and I don't sleep so well in general anymore. We're adult, we're old now. So, but we got through the night, we survived. We're about to hit the car and head to our next destination, so come along with us. I always wanted to do this. Okay, so we are heading off to our destination. I don't think we've revealed what that is yet. You guys should know by now if you've been watching the channel for any time. We are going to Apple Annie's today. We're actually going to make a couple stops though. We're heading off to their apple orchard first, where I hear a rumor that they have a pancake breakfast. And all I had to hear was cider syrup. Looking really forward to that. And then we're going to be heading to the pumpkin patch, but not on this episode. That's going to be a different episode. But you're going to get a little taste of some Apple Annie's freshness today. All right, we have arrived at Apple Annie's orchard. We're here to seek out pancakes. They better have them, or I'm gonna be really grumpy. Got some apples on display here, but yeah, we have cider donuts here too. They make them fresh on the premises. And here's where the orchards start. They have apples primarily. I think they also have some kind of pear that you could pick right now. They got little picnic tables set up in there to eat your pancake breakfast. I think the pancake breakfast is right over here. Alrighty, so so Amy got, you had your choice of pumpkin pancakes or buttermilk, right? Mm-hmm. So I got buttermilk, Amy got pumpkin, so we'll sample each thing. And then you get your choice of apple, was it apple cider syrup?
I think so, yeah.
Or maple syrup. And I got the cider syrup, and I think Amy did too. And then you get a coffee or juice also. So we'll go look at our stash here in a second. All right, so here's what we're dealing with this morning. This is why Amy and I got up early and came down here, was to have this little pancake breakfast before we head over to the pumpkin patch. We believe those are the pumpkin pancakes, and I think these are the buttermilk. They didn't mark them, but those look darker, so we're making an assumption. You get a little bit of sausage here with that, and a couple butters, and they put the syrup on there for you already. So Amy is saying, shut up, Glenn, let's eat. All right, I prepared the first bite. Let's taste this. So this would be the buttermilk pancake with cider syrup. Going in for the kill. That syrup is wonderful, actually. I mean, what do you think, Amy? Do you taste that syrup?
My eyes nearly popped out of my head. It's really good.
I would say this exceeds our expectations, just like Popeye's last night. 2 for 2 so far. All right, pumpkin. I could eat that. I'm not as huge of a pumpkin fan as Amy. Amy is a pumpkin fanatic. But that is really good. You really can taste the pumpkin, I would say, right? It's really prominent. So if you like pumpkin, I mean, definitely, if you like any pancakes, then this is the place to come, but the pumpkin is delicious too, but I like my buttermilk. All right, I'm gonna kind of dip the sausage here in the syrup. A little tough, I would say, at first glance. The spork was kind of bending, so I just stabbed it with a knife. So let's go in for the bite. Actually, way, way better than I thought it was going to be. It almost tastes like Jimmy Dean sausage at first, but it's kind of got a char-grilled flavor to it. I think they probably cook it on that same grill where they barbecue hot dogs and hamburgers at lunch. So quite delicious, actually. What do you think of the sausage, Amy?
That's good.
Yeah,
that's,
it really is. Flavor. Yeah, it does have a lot of flavor.
It's a little on the tough side, but
yeah, it is. But
the flavor
still
really makes up for it.
It really does. So excellent, everything all around, really good. So I mean, score high points for the food. Absolutely delicious. But the ambience, just eating here in the orchard itself. I didn't know that you could do that. And they've got like multiple rows set up with lots of tables. Really beautiful morning light, kind of on the tops of the trees here. Really nice and quiet. Man, like this is a 10 out of 10, I would say. This is awesome. So you can see, you know, that they have these little signs on there, and when you're finished, Amy, do the honors. So we didn't really come today to pick apples or anything. It's just Amy and I, so, you know, picking apples, you're gonna end up with like a whole bag of them, but for now, we're just gonna go poke our heads in some of those rows over there, take a look, and then maybe jump into the store. And I'm looking for trees that have apples in them. That's all I wanna see, is a tree with apples in them. All right, so lots of apples on the ground. I'm gonna guess a lot of these are just picked clean. Probably have to go deeper in here to find more. There's Rome Beauties. If you've ever wondered what an apple tree looks like, here you go. Now, I'm just exploring for the first time back here, granted, so I've never been here. I mean, the orchard goes way down that way, and there's still more rows that I haven't explored, but it seems like the deeper you go, the more apples you find. Makes sense. Less distance you have to haul them. Oh yeah, here we go. I don't know if those look ready. I mean, tiny apples, but I'm assuming those are probably Granny Smith also. Those look nice, actually. Those look really nice up there. So we're inside the bakery and fudge kitchen. Smells good in here too. You got apple cider, Amish style butter, summer sausage, ghost pepper cheese. Look at these pies. What is a hot peach? So Amy and I find ourselves now at Apple Annie's Produce and Pumpkin Farm, about 6-7 miles away from where we had that wonderful breakfast. We're here picking our 2020 pumpkins out. We actually did an entire video on this. If you already have not seen it yet, I'll put a link in the description down below. We've already went ahead and released that one just because Halloween's sneaking up on us, but definitely don't miss out on that one. But yeah, this is one of our favorite places to come each year. So Amy has taken our pumpkins for 2020. She's actually paying for them. Gonna haul them back to the car. Yeah, I'm making her do all the hard work. But yeah, this road trip has been amazing. What a better way to burn off that breakfast, right? Than coming out here. We went in that corn maze right behind me. We were in there for almost an hour. Then went out and picked some pumpkins out in this warm desert sun. Definitely, I think, more than burned off those calories, hopefully. Probably not, but man, that was fun. All right, I gotta go find Amy now. Yeah, I'm kind of like bummed because I would say the road trip's not over yet because we have to drive 3 hours back to Phoenix. So don't go anywhere just yet. We're not calling it. Not sure what we're gonna do for the rest of the day, but yeah, I'm just hanging out in the shade now. Just loving that landscape before I have to go back to the work week, which I'm dreading. Man, am I dreading that. We're still stuffed from breakfast. The kettle corn smells amazing. You really would like some, but man, I couldn't imagine eating anything else after that breakfast for a very long time. And it's lunchtime and I'm still not hungry. All right, so we are heading back home to Phoenix. Got a 3-hour drive ahead of us here. So we're probably gonna part ways with you, but really quick, it was a great little overnight road trip. The highlights, Amy and I just discussed it. I think our highlights were the thing, which we're actually just passing right now. That was really fun, and the updated version of that was fantastic. You'll see a video of that coming out here soon. Then the breakfast this morning, out on that apple orchard in the shade, the food was phenomenal, and it was just a perfect moment. Just one of those things that you didn't really expect to turn out as good as it did. 10 out of 10 there. And Apple Annie's Produce and Pumpkin Farm, always just so much fun. Love this year's corn maze, more challenging than last year's, but that's a no-brainer. That's always fun. So we really, really enjoyed having you guys join along with us, and we look forward to another road trip sometime here in the future. So thanks a lot, and see you next time. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.